I am upset that I cannot fall in love, but I guess.
Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, or welcome to my channel if you're new. My name is McCullough. Recently, I've been on a Netflix binge. So if you would like to get an idea of what new Netflix show that you should watch or what new movie you should watch, then continue watching. I wrote down everything on the computer and all the plot stuff. So if I'm looking down, which I will be, that is why. The first show I would recommend is the show called Manifest. This is what I am currently watching on Netflix. I just started watching this with my mom 3 days ago, and we are already on season 2 because it is that good. Manifest is about the passengers of Flight 828 who realize that the world has aged 5 years and that everyone around them has aged 5 years after they get off of their flight, but they have stayed the same age. So after everyone on Flight 828 got off their flight and they are now settled in, they start experiencing supernatural events, which they are now calling The Calling. Such events include hearing things, seeing visions, and I can't really give that much more away without giving away the plot and the events that happen in the show. But just know that this is a really, really good show, and if you are into supernatural events, this is definitely the show for you. Next show that I would recommend is Glee. Obviously, I'm going to recommend this because I'm a theater kid and I love Glee. Glee is about a group of ambitious misfits that try to escape the harsh realities of high school by joining the Glee Club, which is headed by a passionate Spanish teacher, Will Schuster. Will Schuster becomes the director of the school's failing Glee Club, The New Directions. He hopes to be able to rejuvenate it. This club has everyone from football players, cheerleaders, to just nerds in general joining forces and joining forces sounds so weird, but you know, becoming friends and meeting each other, basically defeating the stereotype of high school. And while they are doing this, they are getting relentlessly bullied and picked on by everyone around them, but they managed to stay together. My favorite part of Glee is during the Christmas time because I absolutely love their Christmas soundtrack because they always sound amazing. Next Netflix show I would recommend is Anne with an E. If you've seen Anne of Green Gables, I'm pretty sure that you will love Anne with an E because it is pretty, it's Anne of Green Gables but turned into a show. Anne of Green Gables follows the adventure of a young orphan girl named Anne living in the late 19th century. This says, follow Anne as she learns to navigate her new life on Prince Edward Island, which is an island of her imagination that she made up. Elderly siblings Marilla and Matthew Cuthbert adopted her. They thought she was going to be a boy because they wanted to adopt a boy who would work on the farm with Matthew, but they were given Anne instead, who was clearly not a boy. Instead, he ended up taking her home, and they started falling in love with this little girl and decided to keep her. The show follows Anne going through meeting new friends and experiencing life as a now adopted non-orphan. My next Netflix recommendation is The Haunting of Hill House. In the summer of 1992, Hugh and Olivia Crane and their 5 children, Stephen, Shirley, Theodora, Luke, and Eleanor, also known as Nell, moved into Hill House to renovate the mansion in order to sell it and build their own house, designed by Olivia. However, due to unexpected repairs, they had to stay longer, and they began to experience increasing paranormal phenomena, resulting in a tragic loss and their family fleeing from the house. 26 years later, the Crane siblings and their estranged father reunite after tragedy strikes them again, and they are forced to confront how their time in Hill House has affected each of them. I can't really say a whole lot more without giving it away, so I'm just gonna stick with reading the premise of the show. The next show that I'm going to give you, you have to bear with me. This movie series gets a lot of crap. I understand why, but I also don't understand why. Your guilty pleasure mixed with you're totally not guilty about it. This show is Twilight. I know what you're thinking, McCullough, Twilight is not on Netflix. Well, guess what? Spoiler alert, the entire movie series of Twilight is coming to Netflix July 16th. And I found this out through Facebook. I am super excited for this and I feel like you should be too. If you don't know what Twilight is about, which I don't know how you wouldn't, Twilight tells the story of Bella Swan and the vampire she falls in love with, Edward Cullen. Bella moves to the small and rainy town of Forks, Washington to live with her father after her mother remarries. She hates the rain, but at least she fits in better in Forks than she did with her Hugh High School in Phoenix, Arizona. The next show that I'm going to recommend you is Cobra Kai. Karate Kid is one of my favorite movies ever, so I am very glad that they made the show. Miguel, an asthmatic kid who lives with his Ecuadorian single mother Carmen and grandmother Rosa, asks Johnny to teach him. Initially reluctant, Johnny finally agrees and decides to reopen the Cobra Kai Karate Dojo as a chance to recapture his past. However, this act reawakens his rivalry with Daniel LaRusso. The next show I am going to recommend is Ginny and Georgia. Ginny and Georgia is an American romantic drama comedy series created by Sarah Lampert. The series follows Ginny, a 15-year-old who is more mature than her 30-year-old mother, Georgia, in a New England town where Georgia decided to settle down with her daughter, Ginny, and son. So Ginny and Georgia, pretty much again, like this set, follows 15-year-old Ginny. And she is going through life at her new high school, so she moves around a whole lot. So she never really made a whole lot of friends, but after she moved to this one specific town, she started meeting all of these friends. There's a little love triangle going on with her neighbor boy and her boyfriend. The next movie I recommend is Bird Box. Bird Box's plot revolves around the uprising of supernatural creatures which surface the worst fears and regrets in the minds of people who make visual contact. That would explain the blindfolds. There's a lot of suspense and horror. The next movie I recommend is kind of like the opposite of Bird Box, and it is The Silence. The Silence is kind of like the knockoff version of A Quiet Place. When a group of cave explorers unleashes a dangerous species of blind flying creatures called Vesps from an underground mine, the population on Earth is attacked and killed by them. The government finds that the creatures attack through the human sound and requests people to stay quiet at home. However, the constructor Hugh Andrews decides to move to the countryside with his wife Kelly, their teenage daughter Allie, who lost her hearing a couple years ago in a car accident, their son Jude, and Kelly's mother Lynn, who has lung cancer, and their dog Otis in the family car. Their friend Glenn joins them in his own car, but Glenn has a car accident and attracts the Vesps. Later, Hugh and his family leave the car and walk, communicating only in sign language, seeking shelter in the countryside. I was on the edge of my seat the entire time. The Vesps are creepy looking. It kind of gave me off Jurassic Park vibes. They looked like flying pterodactyls. The next movie I recommend is Legally Blonde. Elle Woods has it all. She's the president of her sorority, a Hawaiian tropic girl, Miss June in her campus calendar, and above all, a natural blonde. She dates the cutest fraternity boys on campus and wants nothing more than them to be Mrs. Warner Huntington III. There's just one thing stopping Warner from popping the question. Elle is too blonde. Growing up across the street from Aaron Spelling might mean something in Los Angeles, California, but nothing to Warner's East Coast blue blood family. So when Warner packs up for the Harvard Law School and reunites with his old sweetheart from prep school, Elle rallies all her resources and gets into Harvard, determined to win him back. But law school is a far cry from the comforts of her poolside and mall. Elle must wage the battle of her life for her guy, for herself, and for all the blondes who suffer endless indignities every day. Legally Blonde is one of those movies, it kind of reminds me of, it's like Mean Girls, but without the mean girls, if that makes sense. It kind of has that vibe to it. Last show suggestion that I am going to recommend today is The Haunting of Bly Manor. The Haunting of Bly Manor series plots tells the story of a young governess hired by a man to look after his niece and nephew at the family country house, the Bly Manor, after they fall into his care. Arriving at the Bly estate, she begins to see apparitions that proceed to haunt that premises. Crazier and crazier with each show and episode you get. It's one of those things where it kind of leaves you on a cliffhanger on the last show, so you have to watch the next episode in order to be satisfied, but then it leaves you on another cliffhanger, and then you have to watch that show to be satisfied, which is really frustrating at times, but you know. Thank you guys for watching this video. Be sure to like and subscribe for more videos. Comment down below any video suggestions that you would like, and until next time, goodbye. We ain't ever gonna-